What is up, everybody? Welcome to another episode. Today, as promised, we're going to talk about medium format cameras. But this is not going to be the typical medium format camera episode. I have something interesting to talk about. Many of you, including me, you're on a budget, right? And we are in trying times. And for photographers that they especially do freelancing, getting our hands to a new gear that is new and strong and powerful might be a little tricky. Now, some of us don't really want to go down the road of payments and credit cards and all that crap, you know? Because especially freelancing sucks when it comes to buying new gear, because you don't know when your next client is gonna come. You gotta play ball with your budgets, income, whatever. So it's been a long time that I have been thinking that I need a mirrorless full-frame camera. So I've been trying to buy one. Turns out my budget was not very good, so I ended up buying a Pentax KP, which is a small compact DSLR camera. It's not mirrorless, it's not full frame, but throughout the year and me playing around with the camera, I realized that it's a pretty good camera. I still had the need to go big, so throughout my research I realized that there is actually a choice that is very, very cheap that can give you truly incredible results. And that is a medium format film camera. Now, there are many of you that they don't live close to a place that develops films. Now, this is something that is troublesome for many photographers, that they want to shoot film because there are no places to develop it or scan it. Some of us do it ourselves, some of us ship it somewhere and it comes like a month later. Now, for those of you that they have a lab nearby, like myself, like I feel very lucky to have a store, a place, a business that they do amazing lab development and scanning and all that. The first thing I did was look for this kind of business nearby. As soon as I found it, then I started looking, because having a medium format camera, it kind of is like owning a very powerful digital full frame camera. It is, because the 120 millimeter film is a big, big film. It gives you a lot of information. And the first time I saw my first frame as a digital file, I was blown away. So as soon as I bought my camera and I got my lens, I started shooting. I started doing tests, and it covered that gap that I needed in my work. Yes, I know it's a hustle shooting film, but as soon as you get used to it and you are familiar with developing and understanding which film is the best for you, you're gonna do great. And trust me, the results are gonna blow you away. So, enough talk. I'm gonna show you the camera that I have. This is my Pentax 645. I know, I'm really into Pentax, whatever. It's just a habit. Like the first brand I always look at is this, because I have a lot of lens and I have a history with this and I'm familiar with the models, and I'm not one of these photographers that they spend months looking for the perfect model. Like, as soon as it does its job and I'm familiar with the system, whatever. So the 645 is an old camera, but it's still in the market. There are still a lot of lenses to choose. This camera is cheap. If you're thinking in terms of, I want to buy a film camera, it's not cheap. It will cost you more than a usual SLR camera. Now, if you think on terms that I want to buy a cheap full frame camera that can produce large images that they're high quality, these guys are very handy and very cheap. Now, I got the body of this camera around $380, and the lens were around $220, I think. Yes, it took me a while to find the right lens and to find a right condition, because I didn't want something really, really messed up and old and weathered. I wanted something that feels new to me and is in good quality so I can invest and keep it for a long time. So this camera felt really, really good in my hand because she has a grip, like comparing to other medium format film cameras, that they're usually just the box. And you have your top visor, viewer on the top. This version of the 645, it films like an SLR. Like you hold it and you look through it. You don't have to look from above and mirror everything. She has a really strong grip, and I wanted to buy a small lens but powerful. So I got a 45 millimeter. Lens that gives you all the way to 2.8. It's not very bright, but for a medium format, 2.8 is actually very good. Now, this particular camera, she takes 6 AA batteries, which is a lot, but it's worth it. Like I can use 2 rolls of film, and then the battery might start getting like a little weird. Like for example, I remember when I used my second roll and I finished it, the rewind was kind of slow. So I had to double check and manually rewind the film just to be sure. But she already rewinded it anyways. But I wouldn't go on 3 rolls with a set of batteries. So I shot a lot of rolls with this one, and then after I felt that I'm very comfortable and very confident with her, I took her in an actual photo shoot. I shot some wedding pictures, and I used her mainly as my secondary camera. So I had her on around my neck the whole time, and I was shooting with my DSLR, and there were some certain shots that I shot the same exact shot with both of them, and I just wanted to have a comparison on how the DSLR looks and how the medium format looks, and their results are majestic. As soon as I saw how different the images look, I felt like I own a full frame camera, because I tried to use, I had on my DSLR, I had a 18-55 lens, so I immediately turned it into a 45, like I fixed it there, so I can have the same similar results, and I was blown away. That difference satisfied me in such a way, and now I'm like, I don't need anything else, like I have all I want. And the lab had the option to scan it like in high, super high resolution. So if you want to print big, you can. It's a film. Like, it doesn't lose its quality. It all depends on the film you're going to pick. If you want to pick a low ISO film, you will have tremendous quality. You're going to have tremendous clarity. The view, the depth of field, everything is amazing. It feels high end. I couldn't believe that I had this camera, because when I was a kid, I remember thinking that medium format cameras are extremely professional and you have to be very special, like you have to be a magazine photographer to use. And me holding this camera and shooting and developing and seeing the results, I was amazed. I was like, this is incredible that I managed to get this camera on this budget and I can shoot daily with this camera now. So if you are desperate in buying a full frame expensive camera but you don't have the money for it, I advise you that you should look into medium format film cameras with a nice lens for you that is right for you and give it a try, because you will love this. I can show you some of my scan photos that I shot with my cats and all that, and you can see that this is a very good opportunity. So give it a shot, like if you're on a budget, and even if you don't have a DSLR or you have a very cheap old DSLR and you're desperate in changing your gear and you want something good, give it a try. Like, try to find a medium format film camera. They are cheap, not extremely cheap. They are cheap though for what you're getting, and trust me, it's worth it. Like, it's really, really worth it. She has a beautiful sound. It's a little intimidating. Recapping, give those a try, look them up. Maybe this will give you the solution that you're looking for on your budget. Yes, films are not very cheap, especially the 120 millimeter films are not cheap. You can buy some bundles that they are cheaper instead of buying one piece at a time. Look for if you have any labs in your city, in your neighborhood, that they can actually scan and develop medium format films. If you have all that, it's just an alternative choice of having a budget camera that can produce incredible images. This is it, guys. I hope you liked that video. I hope it's informative. Again, I didn't want to do a review of this particular camera because the point of this video was not to just tell you what to buy, but to let you know that you have an alternative choice in case you want something different that produces incredible images but you are on a budget. So thanks for watching. I hope you guys like this video. Subscribe to our channel because we have a lot of things coming. I have something very interesting coming up, something very vintage-y, and some of you might really like this. It's gonna be kind of like a funny, interesting video, so I'm not gonna tell you what it is. It's gonna ruin the surprise. But I hope you guys like this video, and I'm gonna see you in the next episode. Thanks for watching, guys.